and welcome to week 20. Let me show you what today's quick tip is about. You see a ruffle top right here, and you can see here that the ruffle is a regular brush that I created. And sometimes this regular brush continues on and on and on with no variation. We want to create some width variation, make it a little bit more tapered. And that's how we're going to achieve this look right here. And all we need to do is expand and then have some lucker, plucker, have some pucker and bloat options. Well, anyways, this is Ludmilla Adams from Fashion Chalkboard. You're watching 52 weeks of fashion sketching in Adobe Illustrator. Remember that this download is in the free member area at fashionchalkboard.com. The link is below the video. And as always, you'll have some goodies that are in here, such as the sketch, such as the brush, and then also you have a print in here that's a watercolor geometric. All right, let's begin. So I'm just gonna go and go on this layer. Hold on, let me show you what's actually in the free file again. So it's three colorways. I almost forgot to say that. And I'm just gonna go on empty, almost empty layer, and I'm going to use my pen tool, and I'm going to draw with a stroke, and I'm just going to redraw what I have here. So I'm just a line on a diagonal, and then I'm going to click on my brush, and the brush that I used here is actually 0.2, so I'm gonna pretty much mimic that. And then if we were to use the options, which are hidden under the width tool, here the pucker and bloat on a brush, you can see how it reshapes it, but it's not really making it bloat. So I'm gonna just undo all these little things with Command Z, Control Z, and I'm gonna show you that you can go to Object, Expand Appearance, and then you'll have this expanded version. And then when you select it, and then you go to your, let's do bloat again, and you click on top of any of these, how it actually makes it a little bit bigger. Now, I don't know what your settings are going to be when you come in using these. And you can see also that my repeat is kind of revealed here. There's a couple of things that we have to pay attention to. Let me just finish this up a little bit. So here is also my pucker. And you can see how if I click, you can see how if I click with that, how it kind of narrows it in at these positions. And I'm going to undo this and do this a couple more times and show you a couple of things that we can do to control this a little bit better. So the first thing is when we go to Object, Expand Appearance, you'll see that my brush is kind of divided into these pieces the way that I created the brush. So one of the things we can do is make these components here, which are two, into one. And the way to do this really quickly is to use our Shape Builder tool. So I can just click on these here, hold down Shift, and then go to my Shape Builder tool and just rub over these. So now they are one. So we can control this a little bit better. Now, once I made them into one, you can see that some of the pieces that are for the coloring here became jumped to the front. So once I click on this group, I can ungroup it and then just kind of decide what I want to go into what position. So right now, there's just this piece pretty much still grouped. So ungroup that and then click on these with Shift. Send it to the back. Just like that. In the pucker and bloat option, if you double click on them, you have a couple of different options here. You can specify the intensity, and I'm gonna just exaggerate this so you can see that you could have this at 100. You could also have this brush a lot bigger, so let's say we have this 2 by 2 inches. And then if I zoom out, you can see how big that bloat option is. So don't be surprised if you click on it and this happens, which is a little bit exaggerated, right? So you could also try and do a little bit less going on an edge like here or like here. But in essence, you need to learn how to set these up right. So for me, so I'm going to do 0.5 by 0.5, and then my intensity, I had it at 30, but let's see what happens if I do 1. So now you can see if I click, less things happen. 1% is really low, 30 I kind of like. So once again, with double click, open the pucker tool options, I have width and height at 0.5. I don't want an angle, intensity 30%. You can play with the detail and simplify options. Maybe don't want to simplify this at all. And let's do this real quick here and see what happens from there. So you can see if I press too long, how it kind of disappears. But if I go just lightly over it, just one click, and maybe another one, I have a little bit more control. And you can always undo. Notice the difference when you're doing this between just a quick click versus a hold down, how you create something like that. All right, so what I did in essence with my drawing here is I created a clipping mask. Inside of that clipping mask, I went ahead and I double-clicked into it, then expanded it, and then did my pucker and bloat. And when I had one side, all I did is click on it, transform, reflect, make a copy of it, so that I didn't have to do it for both sides. And then I created my multiple colorways. I hope you like this tip, pucker and bloat. Let's practice those words. And you guys can definitely have a lot of fun distorting all sorts of things with this. If you've never experienced this before, let me know that you find this interesting, if you find it annoying. Maybe you come up with some other ideas. I'll think about some more and see what else we can do with this. I like sometimes using this also to create more volume in fashion illustrations, the entire croquis wearing the garments. So just let me know what you're gonna do with this. Visit me on Instagram, follow me at, you can find me if you put in hashtag flatsketch52. Also label your own stuff that way so I can see what you're up to. Like the video, subscribe, and have a wonderful day. Bye!